Hello everyone, we are now going to study the half control bridge, which is also called the semi converter. Here we have two SCRs and two diodes and a load connected across it. First of all, we are going to supply this with a sine wave, and the connections are such that an SCR is connected, S1 is connected across the load, and so as the SCR2, this forms a circuit. So when the positive cycle is there, then the current flows from positive to negative, such as S1, then to load, then goes to D2 and then to a negative terminal, and in the reverse bias it goes from S3, then the load, then D4 and then the negative. The power circuits consist the SCR. So for SCR we need to have some pulses, and which are given by the SCR drivers. They are connected respectively, that is SCR driver 1 is given to the gate of SCR1, and SCR driver 3 is given to the gate of 3, and these are generated with respect to the ramp signal from here, which will be varying with the help of a pot. Now when we are giving the pulses, that is in a sine wave, we have 0 degree, 180 degree and 360 degrees, which has the frequency of 50 hertz. So time is given by 1 by f, which is 1 by 50, so 20 milliseconds is corresponding to 360 degrees. That is, for 360 degrees we have 20 milliseconds. For the half part, we have 180 degree gives for 10 milliseconds. Similarly, if we consider 18 degrees, we have 1 millisecond, or 1 millisecond corresponds to 18 degrees. The formula for calculating the theoretical value is VDC is equal to Vm upon pi into 1 plus cos of alpha. Now we'll be moving to the connection part. So first of all, we are having the driver circuits connected to the gate. So driver of SCR1 driver is given to the gate of 1, and SCR driver 3 is given to the gate of SCR3. Then according to the circuit diagram, we have the negative, that is anode, given to cathode of SCR1. Then we have the fourth, the diode given to this, and this second diode given to the third one. Now we need to connect the load. There are three types of loads, so we are using this resistive load. We have two loads. The resistive load is connected to this, and the negative is shorted with the diodes. These two are internally shorted. Now for calculation, we use two devices, that is, one is a DMM and one is a CRO. So the DMM gives us the practical value, and with the help of CRO, we get the theoretical value also.
Theoretical means calculated.
Positive of DMM is given across the load. And the negative to the negative of the load. Similarly, we connect the terminals of the CRO respectively. And now we switch on the kit. As you can see, the values are
we can change alpha by
The value of alpha will be changed accordingly with the help of the ramp signal, that is, we are using the potentiometer over here.
And how to measure alpha? Experiment and show one theoretical practical matching. Ye practical value hai actually, udhar se jo lenge na millisecond wo calculate jo karenge theoretical value.
Start. Now using the potentiometer, we are varying the alpha.
Accordingly, voltage changes.
The voltage accordingly changes whenever we are changing the alpha. When the alpha is increased, the voltage level decreases, as you can see the drop in the voltage as we are increasing the alpha. Now in the CRO, there is a line in the below side of the CRO. This is the non-conducting period. This alpha is a non-conducting period in the output of ours. So this alpha, accordingly, if we measure with the help of the x-axis, it gives us the value of. It's approximately 0.4. So 0.4 into the time division knob is into 5. So 0.4
into 5 is
2. So 0.4 into 5 is equal to 2 milliseconds. And now this 2 milliseconds is varied since our 1 millisecond.
In degree you write.
Since our 1 millisecond corresponds to 18 degrees. So 2 milliseconds corresponds to 36 degrees. Now for putting this value of alpha in the formula above, we have the Vm over here can be calculated by 18 volts, which is the secondary of the transformer, into root 2. So we can see Vd as 18 into root 2, which approximately gives us 25.2. Now putting this value over here, 25.2 upon pi into 1 plus cos of 36. Calculating this value, we get 14.51.
And here we're getting 14.8.
And this approximately, this
VM
gives us 14.8.
This is for 1 reading.
So this gives us the theoretical value which we have calculated using this formula, and this gives us the practical value which we have calculated using the DMM. Similarly, other values can be calculated when we using the potentiometer, that if we change the value using potentiometer, the value over here decreases, and then again measuring the alpha angle from here and multiplying it into this, we get the alpha, through which we have to again put it into this formula and calculate the other values over here. So when the alpha angles are calculated over here, we can get the theoretical and practical values in such an angle. Considering we have calculated the angle from 18 degrees to 108 degrees variation, we get the variations when alpha is increasing, the voltage level is continuously decreasing in both theoretical and practical values. So you can see when we are varying the alpha angle, when we are varying the potentiometer, the alpha angle is changing over here, and similarly the value in potentiometer is changing here. Alpha is also called as the firing angle. So like this we can perform the half controlled bridge. Thank you for watching our video.